Hey everyone, this week I'm going to be talking about the hypocrisy coming from the Republicans on hurricane relief, how Joel Osteen finally found God. We'll be talking about the new homophobe that Trump wants in his cabinet, and I'm going to introduce you to one of my favorite allies on the planet, comedian, activist, and actress Suzanne Wong. I'm Dana Goldberg, and you are watching Out in Left Field. Now, I think we know that what's happening in Texas is no laughing matter. However, the hypocrisy coming from the right legislation is a joke. After voting against a bill that would have given hurricane relief to Sandy victims, Ted Cruz, super creepy, is now asking for federal relief to help with the hurricane. Cruz voted against the Sandy bill originally because he said so much of it had nothing to do with the hurricane. He said that two-thirds of it was full of pork. Well, we researched that and it turns out two-thirds of Ted Cruz is full of shit. The final bill actually included things that would help all victims of Hurricane Sandy across the East Coast and into the Caribbean. Cruz's excuse was, it's not right for politicians to exploit a disaster when people are hurting. You mean like tweeting about funding a wall? Or, hey, here's a link to buy this book. Or, I don't know, pardoning a racist in the middle of a hurricane because TV ratings are higher?
A lot of people think it was the right thing to do, Joan. And actually, in the middle of a hurricane, even though it was a Friday evening, I assumed the ratings would be far higher than they would be normally. You know, the hurricane was just starting.
So, Ted, you're right. What kind of horrible politician would do that? Well, I think you answered your own question. And Republicans aren't the only ones sounding hypocritical in the wake of Hurricane Harvey. Joel Osteen, who runs this mega church in Houston, said that he wasn't opening his doors because there was too much flooding around the building. As pictures of his church started to pour in, backlash on social media came in epic proportion, biblical if you will. After Lakewood Church got the word from God, probably in 140 characters or less, they decided that they would open the doors after the shelters in Houston started to fill up. Joel, since you're a man of God, why don't you just open your doors now and start letting everyone in two by two? In other news, it seems that more bigots are making the list of Trump nominees. In addition to being one of Trump's bigot birther buddies, say that five times fast, his new appointee is also a very misguided homophobe. Shocking, I know, what? He wants to appoint Sam Clovis to be USDA chief scientist, but Sam has no background in science, no scientific background, none. Clovis is upset because if our community is protected by the 14th Amendment, then these pastors can't actually preach that our alternative lifestyle goes against church doctrine. Oh no, what would they possibly preach about? I don't know, love, acceptance? I know, that's not very Christ-like. Clovis expressed that if the LGBTQ community got marriage equality, then they're going to be pushing the limit to polyamorous arrangements. I tell you what, Sam, some of this community already have polyamorous relationships, and they're working out great. Not me. I'm exhausted between the marching, the protesting. I want to marry one person, I want to have a snack, and then I want a nap. That's all I have the energy for. And speaking of energy, someone that seems to have boundless amounts of it is my guest this week, my dear friend, comedian, actress, and activist, Suzanne Wong. Thank you so much for coming back and joining us this week. My guest is one of my favorite people on the planet. She was the host of House Hunters 10 years running. She was my favorite character, Polly, on the series Las Vegas. And you may have seen her on the series From Here On Out, right here at Here TV. Out in Left Field, please welcome to the show my friend, Suzanne Wong.
Yeah! And the crowd goes wild.
So crazy, everyone in the audience. Thank you so much for coming.
Yay.
I adore this woman. You make all kinds of great things happen in this world. You are a huge ally for the LGBTQ community. So you actually created a comedic character.
Her name is Sung-hee Park. She's fresh off the boat from Seoul, South Korea. She's never done stand-up comedy before. What if she were terrible? What if she just is naive and innocent and wants to do good comedy in Hollywood? And what if she's racist, but she doesn't even realize it? What if she's vulgar? And it turned into this whole satire on racism and stereotypes. And so one of my jokes is, just imagine me in the dress. One of my jokes is, you know condom? Okay, two condom walking down the street, you know, and they passing a gay bar, and one say to other, let's go in, get shit-faced. It's just a terrible joke. They're awful jokes.
The audience loves them.
I thought I knew what it was like to kill in a comedy club until I went to Provincetown.
Oh.
and I did this act in front of 350 gay men. I thought the building was going to just crumble to the ground from the reverberation of the screaming and laughing. Because my Sung Hee Park character is basically a fish out of water. Yeah. She's disenfranchised. People don't understand her. It's not going well for her.
Right.
You know what I mean? And there's something endearing about that.
Other things that you do that have been magic, yes. You are actually a survivor of stage 4 breast cancer.
Right. So I've had breast cancer 3 times in the past 10 years because, like most Asians,
you're
I'm
an
overachiever.
What?
I never asked for help when I needed it. I never asked for love and help. I always gave love and help. And in Asian culture, which is probably true for other cultures as well, you're supposed to go, oh no, everything perfect. Don't worry. I'm very healthy. Everything great. You know, you're just supposed to pretend everything's fine, right. And it's ridiculous. But as soon as I came out of the cancer closet on social media and just with my family, friends, and fans, my heart cracked open and I received this tsunami of love and support from people that I didn't even know all over the world. And I was literally loved back to life.
One of the things that I find so powerful about you is that you are able to cross-pollinate all of this activism that you've done with your own journey. So when Trump was elected, you were able to take your personal journey with cancer and liken it to an election that everyone would understand. And you made a blog post. It says, Trump winning the presidential election is this country's diagnosis of stage 4 cancer. It's a wake-up call. We've discovered a giant malignant tumor in the heart of America, and it is not time to go numb or move away, because it's time to rally, step up, focus on our vision for the future. We need to think globally, act locally, address the shadows of our own psyches that are being unearthed by this election. We are giving birth to a new version of humanity. Giving birth is extremely painful, but on the other side of it is a beautiful new life. So keep breathing, keep believing, and keep your eye on the dream.
I liked that.
This is so important for me to read daily, because usually I wake up, read the news, and I want to tell the entire administration to go fuck themselves.
I know. Trump is the tumor with hair and teeth. Cutting it off, that doesn't solve the problem. It is sort of the visible symptom of the problem, but the problem is systemic. And the solution is not just to get rid of Trump. That is one of the solutions, absolutely.
It's get a very
him,
important
get
part
him
of
the
it.
Fuck out of there, yes. Right? But it's sort of like then another tumor grows and another tumor right. grows until you solve it systemically. And part of what I believe is that cynicism used to seem like an act of rebellion, but it's actually obedience. Because if you're cynical and you feel like there's nothing that you can do that's going to change anything,
right.
That's what the powers that be want. So what we need to be is revved up, optimistic, and take action.
I feel like I have an arranged marriage with this administration where I was like, I didn't fucking pick this. How
right.
am I supposed to make this work?
Right, but you do have to make it work.
Yeah.
And one of the things that I encourage people to do is, and I know this sounds really horrifying, but where does Donald Trump exist inside of you? Where are your shadow places?
Yeah.
Where are your intolerant places? Where are your judgmental places? Where are your hypocritical places? And work on that. If everyone was doing that kind of investigation, that gets outpictured in the world.
You've been actually involved in a project to bring outward beauty, especially to women, something called the Body Joy Project.
Yes! Yeah. My friend Tracy Newman's daughter, Charlotte Dean, is a visual artist. And the mission of it is to help women embrace what they look like, no matter what they look like, and get rid of this body shaming. We're all trying to achieve some image of physical beauty that has nothing to do with anything other than what
society says is attractive.
Right. There is a tribe in Africa where women's breasts are considered beautiful the more longer and pendulous they are. So they would think that Dolly Parton looked hideous.
Right.
So who is correct?
Well, I'll tell you what, that in Los Angeles, my boobs are a 2, and in Africa, they're a 10.
Nice.
Yes. So I'm just going to put that, or not, they're like a 7.
After the surgeries from my left breast was left scarred and asymmetrical and instead of going, oh, that looks terrible, I need to fix it to look perfect and beautiful, I decided, what if I just reclaimed this as the new beautiful and feminine and sexy for me?
And you did. You started a podcast called The Love Stop with your best friend Vanessa.
Yes, my best friend Vanessa Marcel, who I met on the set of Las Vegas.
Where can we find that?
You can find it on SoundCloud.
Okay.
You just look up Love Stop.
If people would like to find out more about Suzanne Hwang, they can go to her website, which is?
SuzanneHwang.com.
Easy as that. And if you want to see more of Suzanne Hwang, you can actually do that on Netflix. This is her first feature film called A Weekend with the Family. You want to watch it. It's absolutely brilliant, like you are in every role that you do.
Check it out.
Thank you so much for watching, everybody.
Look at this face. Ooh. I love this face.
I love this one. I love that we have these incredible guests. I hope you're enjoying these guests. Make sure if you are, you share these videos so we can make more of them. Again, I'm Dana Goldberg, and you've been watching Out in Left Field.
Hey, everyone. I'm fading. Who are you people behind the camera?
They get Bruce, our buddies. Oh, geez.
Can you make her taller and less
Asian? Is there a less Asian button?
No, as a lesbian, you get back together and get back together and get back together.
Should we make out now?
Totally. That's how straight Asian women and lesbians make out.
You did say I licked your wounds. She said wounds.
Oh, God.
She didn't say womb.
She licked my womb.
She has more than one. She is extra blessed.
I don't like any of you right now.